Hey, everybody. Good
evening.
What
is up, you guys?
My name is Jenna. I'm here at Revive Church tonight. I'm a part of the Dream Team.
And I'm Serena. I'm a part of the media team and the camera crew here at Revive Church San Antonio. Welcome, guys.
Yes, welcome. Tune in. Make sure to share the live tonight, guys. Invite your friends. Invite your family. And
yes,
give us
share
some hearts.
This.
Give us some wow faces.
Reactions. We're going to see right
yes.
now. We're going to try to pull up the live. I hope we're live right now. Let
yes.
us know.
We're waiting for the live to come out
to
in just a minute.
So
we'll
we can
start
shout
you guys out.
But welcome, guys. Happy
yes.
Sunday.
We're happy that you're here.
Yes, definitely.
Yes. I don't know if y'all were in the building last week
Easter.
Oh, my God.
Little recap.
Girl, you guys, it was powerful.
It
the
was
worship
awesome.
Was insane. Like,
oh, my gosh.
I don't know. I don't even have words.
Like, I'm not big for...
There was so much breakthrough.
Yeah, and for myself, I'm not big on being emotional during worship, but it just came natural. Like, I was
yes.
just emotional only because of the presence of God, obviously.
The Holy Spirit was alive and resurrected
yes.
up in this place last week. Like, it was crazy. Yes, it was so good.
Yeah, I love that it's centered on Christ. Of course, I know our kids had a good time. My son told me he
yes.
had such a fun time when we got back in the car, but at least he knew the reason of why. I kept having to tell them it's not about the eggs.
No, even though they like did do like a little egg giveaway or an egg hunt or something with the kids in the
yes.
classrooms, they made it fun for them. But it was
yes.
awesome, man. We had a huge altar call. Pastor Burt preached a powerful word on the resurrection power, and it was so good. I'm just glad I was here.
I know, me too. I was too.
Yes.
And especially after we got to fellowship with everybody. I know everybody stuck around for the food truck and we had a photo
booth. Oh my gosh. Y'all, we had burgers. We
yeah.
had tacos.
Man, they had tacos.
What else was there? There was like five different options and
it was
all on the house from Revive. As
yes.
it was such
thank
a
you, Revive.
Yeah, thank you. We had a cotton candy machine. We had a photo booth.
It was awesome.
The photo booth was dope.
I love that everybody stuck around just for the fellowship and everybody got to just
yes.
hang out and be with their families. I know everybody was together with their family, so
it was so good. It was so much fun.
Yes, most definitely. I'm tuning in now.
Yeah, let's see
it's
who's
kind
on
of
the
pausing
live.
On me. What, I don't know why I always
do. I do
this,
see that we
I
have
Chrissy,
eight people.
Chrissy M. Brantley, welcome, guys.
My
Hello.
Faithful friend.
Hello.
Chrissy's always faithful every Sunday.
Comment, guys, so we can shout y'all out and share this live with
yes,
us.
Yes, so just some other announcements, you guys. We did actually pick up on our Inside Revive tonight. It is week 3, and it was postponed last week due to the Easter service, but
yeah.
we did pick back up this week. We have one more week left. This is how you become a member at Revive Church. It's an amazing 4-week experience where you get to learn about the heart and the vision of the house.
Yes.
And then you get to see where you want to serve.
Yes, most definitely. I love that it's not pressured on you. It's not something that is like pressed on you. I feel like people have just felt
It's
just drawing them
organic.
To want to. Yeah, it's for
yeah.
sure. I think it is. So I'm excited for those that just decided to start.
Yes, we're about
and
to add
believe,
some people to the family.
Yeah.
Next week.
And tell us when the next one.
So the next coming Inside
Since
Revive.
If they couldn't, so today was the
starts
first.
In June.
Yeah, so that you'll have another chance
yeah.
to be able to join again because I think they'll do
yes.
it for the rest of this month, correct?
It is. So next week's week 4, and then starting in June is another round of it. So
okay.
if you guys are interested, make sure to text the word GROW to 830-209-0808.
Yes, awesome. And also, we just did some baptisms,
oh
I think
gosh.
2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Love that.
During our revival service.
Yes. And we dedicated, I think, just a little girl.
One baby.
Yeah, baby girl.
Precious.
Yes.
8 people got baptized.
Yes. 8 people got baptized.
It was amazing. There was a mother and a daughter, too.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah.
So if y'all weren't able to get baptized, if y'all weren't able to dedicate your children, the next baptism will be May 22nd. If you want to just text baptism to 830-209-0808. Sorry,
you got
I saw
it,
your
girl.
Number on there.
You got it.
And so, then the next baby dedication, sorry.
Yes, no, you're good. It's coming up in August.
August 14th. So we'll be sure to remind
yes.
you guys. I know we still have a time gap.
We had to give
then.
Some time to let some more babies be born.
Yeah. So
we can dedicate them to the Lord. Serena's having a baby soon.
Yeah, so maybe. you know what? He will be probably dedicated
be
in August.
When's
yeah.
the due date?
July 17th.
Oh, my
so
gosh.
He'll be able
right
to be
around
there.
The corner.
So we'll be sure to remind you guys about that. But
yeah.
that will be August 14th. And you'll just have to text CHILD to 830-209-0808.
Yes, I'm so excited. So who's on the live? Can
Let's
we
see
who's on
Let
there?
Me go
we can
back.
Shout them
I was
out.
Reading some of my notes.
Yes.
For my friend Jenna.
Also, for those of you who have not been able to connect with Revive Church and you're interested in how you can connect with our community, how yes. you can be a part of the house, you can also text the word connect to 830-209-0808.
Let's just shout out. I saw Yolanda on there and Dale. Welcome,
hey,
guys.
Guys.
If y'all want to share
welcome.
This for us.
Yes.
We're
and
so excited to have you guys.
To share the live.
Share the live, guys. Even on our Instagram, share your posts. Tag us. And we're so happy to have y'all. Get your families together.
Yes.
Gather for our worship experience
get
and the word
Bibles,
from our pastors.
Guys. Get your worship yes. hands, your worship feet ready. Because
yes.
we're about to get started here in the house tonight. We're
yes.
going to have some worship. Some,
I'm excited.
Some word.
Yes.
Some love up in the house.
So thank you guys
yes.
so much. Y'all have a great week. And we'll see y'all
thank
next week.
Thank you for joining us.
Hallelujah. Oh. Say, I'm not afraid. Show you my weakness, all my failures and flaws. Lord, you've seen them all, and He still calls you friend. Oh, 'cause the God of the mountain, He's still the God of the valley. His mercy and grace won't find you again.
Come on, shout it out.
Say there's nothing
yeah.
better than you, God. There's
nothing
better than
you.
Say there's nothing,
nothing is better than you.
Come on, can we just believe that in this place?
Say there's nothing. You turn mourning to dancing. You give beauty for ashes. He turns shame into glory. And He's the only one who can. Come on, say you turn mourning. You turn mourning to dancing. And you give beauty for ashes. Amen.
valley and I thought there was no way through. I called on my Yahweh. I called on my Jireh. I called on my Elohim and he picked me up. He picked me up when I had no faith in myself. He picked me up when I thought there was no way through. And he said, daughter, son, there is nothing I cannot do. There is nothing I will not do. My promise is yes and amen. So we're going to declare that again. And I want you to shout it to the heavens. You turn graves. You turn
into God.
You turn
into God.
Come on, believe it. You turn seas into highways. You're the only one who cares. Come on, I want you to declare that you turn graves.
You turn graves into
God. You turn bones into. You turn seas into. You're the only one who cares. You're the only one. One more time. You're the only one. Only one who cares. Hallelujah. Come on. Lift up a shout of praise. Woo! Come on. Can we just give him some glory? God who is worthy, he turned your graves into gardens. When you were nothing and worthless, he said, you are mine. You belong to me. Come on, can we just give him some glory? For he is worthy to be praised. Woo! Come on, say you turn graves.
You turn graves into
gardens. Come on, you shout it out.
You turn sea, you're the only one.
I want to stay right there, so you turn graves.
You turn graves into garden.
Right there, so you turn graves.
You turn graves into God. You turn graves into
God. That means when you were dead.
He turned graves into God.
On the third day, he rose.
He turned graves into
God.
You turned graves into God. You turned graves.
So you're the only one.
You're the only
one. Hallelujah. Come on, give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise.
Waiting for you.
You move the mountain and I Bring my
we breathe Yahweh. When we breathe out, we breathe Yahweh. Ooh. Oh, we won't let another rock cry out, so revive. Right now in this moment, begin to pour out your worship. Begin to pour out your praise. Pour out the air and the lungs that he gave to you this morning. We are grateful and thankful that we have an opportunity to even praise him. In other countries, it's against the law, but we have freedom right now to give our Savior, our God, our healer, our one, our defender, our champion, some breath, some praise. So get up and praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord, it's your breath. Oh, he loves to hear it. Oh, we pour it out. That sounds good, revive. We pour it out, we pour it out. One more time. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour.
Why would we? Yeah.
wanna be with you, nailed at your feet, Jesus, King of glory, fill this. I just wanna be with you, yeah. I just wanna be with you. One more time, say, King of glory. I just wanna be with you. Oh, I just wanna be with you. I want more. Oh, I want more. Of you, God. Of you, God. We want more. More of your Spirit. More of your presence, more of your blessings, we want more. Oh.
Father, we just thank you tonight, Father.
Padre, solo te queremos dar gracias en esta noche.
We magnify your holy name, Father God, and give you glory, Father.
Magnificamos tu nombre santo y te damos la gloria.
We thank you, Lord.
Te damos gracias, Señor.
That we don't make space, Lord.
Porque no solamente hacemos espacio.
For your presence, Lord.
Para tu presencia.
We give you the space.
Pero te damos el espacio.
This place, Lord, belongs to you.
Este lugar te pertenece, Señor.
And we sanctify ourselves tonight in your presence.
Y nos santificamos en tu presencia.
And we ask that you sanctify us in the Spirit, Lord God.
Y te pedimos, Señor, que en el Espíritu tú nos santifiques.
That we, Lord,
que tú, nosotros, Señor,
can just get closer to you, Lord.
Podamos acercarnos más a ti.
That we can hear you better.
Que te podamos escuchar mejor.
See you better.
Verte mejor.
So that we can just know you better, Lord.
Para que te podamos conocer mejor.
We love you and we magnify you tonight.
Te amamos y magnificamos tu nombre.
We ask that you have your way in this place tonight, Lord.
Pedimos que tú hagas lo que tengas que hacer en este lugar.
That you move in every secret place in our lives.
Que tú te muevas en cada lugar secreto en nuestras vidas.
Every secret place.
Cada lugar secreto.
May it be exposed in your presence, Lord.
Que sean expuestas en tu presencia, Señor.
And may we lay every secret thing at your feet tonight, Lord.
Y que podamos poner todo secreto en tus pies, Señor, en esta noche.
That your name would be glorified.
Para que tu nombre sea glorificado.
Exalted.
Exaltado.
And magnified.
Y magnificado.
Forevermore.
Por siempre más.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
And let the church say amen.
Y la iglesia dice amén.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, we want to welcome you on behalf of Pastor Humberto and Leslie Renovato.
Les queremos dar la bienvenida de parte de nuestros pastores Humberto y Leslie Renovato.
Everybody in the house.
Todos aquí en casa.
And all of our family online.
Y toda nuestra familia en línea.
We love you and we welcome you into his presence tonight.
Los amamos y les damos la bienvenida a su presencia.
Do we have any first-time visitors here tonight?
¿Tenemos alguien aquí por primera vez?
Amen. Welcome.
Amén. Bienvenidos. Welcome. Bienvenidos.
We welcome you. We love you, and we're so glad that you made it.
Les damos la bienvenida, los amamos y contentos de que estén aquí con nosotros.
We're excited.
Estamos emocionados.
To share the presence of God.
De poder compartir la presencia de Dios.
With everyone here tonight.
Con todos aquí en esta noche.
We won't be greedy with him.
No nos vamos a acaparar de ella.
We want everyone to experience his presence, his power.
Queremos que todos experimenten su presencia y su poder.
Each and every day of our lives.
Todos los días de nuestra vida.
And if you're a first-time guest, if you'd like to connect with us,
y si están aquí por primera vez, si quieren conectar con nosotros,
we want you to text CONNECT to 830.
Queremos que manden la palabra CONNECT al 830.
209-209-0808. It should be on the screen
y debería
right there.
Estar en la pantalla.
How many of y'all excited Revive Night is next week?
¿Cuántos están Amen. Emocionados que la noche de avivamiento es el próximo domingo?
First Sunday of every month.
El domingo primero de cada mes.
I get excited.
Yo me emociono.
Because it's like the fire. It's like the fire.
Porque es como el fuego.
That ignites.
Que se prende.
Our month.
Para todo el mes.
And every time we step into that first Sunday of every month,
y cada vez que entramos ese primer domingo de cada mes,
it's like that fire lasts all month long.
Es como que ese fuego dura todo el mes.
And it grows and grows and grows every month that we celebrate and we exalt His name together.
Crece y crece y crece todo el mes en como exaltamos su nombre.
So for those of y'all that aren't familiar with Revive Nights,
para aquellos que no están familiarizados con la noche de avivamiento,
and those of you online that may not be familiar with it would like to experience it with us,
y aquellos en línea que no han experimentado eso con nosotros,
Revive Nights is where we focus on intercession.
Es cuando nos enfocamos en la intercesión.
On passionate praise and worship.
En adoración apasionada.
It's where we birth the creatives.
Es donde nacen los creativos.
Out of the presence of God.
De la presencia de Dios.
We release the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Soltamos el don del Espíritu Santo.
And we activate people in their giftings.
Y activamos a la gente en sus dones.
Because when He ascended on high.
Porque cuando Él ascendió a los cielos.
The word says He gave gifts to men.
La palabra dice que Él dio dones a los hombres.
And for those of you who feel like you're not gifted.
Y a lo mejor te sientes que no tienes algún don.
Jesus said,
Jesús dijo,
when I went up,
cuando yo fui para arriba,
I gifted each and every one of you.
Yo les di dones a cada uno de ustedes.
I always search inside myself at every gift that God placed inside of me and ask myself, God, am I using it to my full potential?
Y yo siempre escudriño dentro de mí y le pregunto a Dios, Señor, todos los dones que has puesto dentro de mí, ¿los estoy utilizando a mi potencia total?
Everybody's gifted in a different way.
Y todos estamos dotados de diferentes maneras.
Pastor Bert is a builder.
El Pastor Humberto, él es alguien que construye.
I'm a builder.
Yo construyo.
God has always pounded me in my spirit.
Dios siempre me ha puesto eso en mi espíritu.
And I always tell my wife.
Y yo siempre le digo a mi esposa.
There's nothing I can do, babe, if I'm not building.
No hay nada que yo pueda hacer si yo no estoy construyendo.
I'm miserable if I'm not building.
Yo me siento miserable si no construyo.
And I sit back and think about it.
Y luego me pongo a pensar.
And I look around.
Y mira a mi alrededor.
And there's so many of us in here that are gifted.
Y hay tantos de aquí que tienen dones.
And you don't realize.
Y no se dan cuenta.
Misery.
La miseria.
Is walking. Is walking.
Es caminar.
Outside.
Fuera
of the gift God's placed in you.
Del don que Dios ha puesto dentro de ti.
But when you start to work that thing.
Pero cuando tú le empiezas a trabajar.
When you start to strike with that gift God gave you.
Cuando tú empiezas a hacer cosas con el don que Dios te ha dado.
You'll start to see fulfillment.
Vas a ver el cumplimiento.
In areas of your life that you never knew existed.
En áreas de tu vida que a lo mejor tú ni sabías que existían.
And that's all part of what we do on Revive Nights.
Y eso es parte de todo lo que hacemos en las noches de avivamiento.
And for me,
y para mí,
it stirs me up every month.
Eso me mueve todos los meses.
I was sitting there and I was listening to Pastor Bert right before service.
Yo estaba sentado y escuchaba al Pastor Humberto antes del servicio.
We have team huddle.
Porque teníamos nuestro momento de equipo.
And he was saying that God spoke to him.
Y él decía que Dios le habló.
And showed him how God was coming forth with like a torch in his hand.
Y Dios le mostraba cómo él venía con una antorcha en su mano.
That the Holy Spirit.
Que el Espíritu Santo
was going to illuminate
iba a iluminar
the very steps and path we take.
Los pasos que fuéramos a dar.
And then he repeated Psalms 119, 105.
Y luego él fue a Salmo 119.
That says thy word.
Y que dice que su palabra.
O Lord.
Señor.
Is a lamp unto my feet.
Es lámpara a mis pies.
And a light unto my path.
Y lumbrera mi camino.
meaning that the Word of God, which is the Spirit of God,
y estar en la palabra de Dios, que es el Espíritu de Dios,
illuminates,
ilumina,
every step we take,
cada paso que damos,
and the path we walk on.
Y cada paso que hacemos.
It reminded me this last week, I was listening to a pastor talking about a scientist he heard.
Y me acuerdo de algo que yo escuché esta semana, de un científico.
And science teaches you,
y la ciencia nos enseña,
the only constant in the universe,
lo único constante en el universo,
is light,
es la luz.
And they believe, scientists believe, if we can get out there and actually get to the speed of light,
y los científicos creen que si nosotros podemos llegar a la rapidez de la luz,
we'll quit aging. That we'll quit aging.
Dejaremos de envejecer.
They really believe that.
Y ellos lo creen.
And then I thought about it.
Y cuando yo me puse a pensar,
and God started speaking to me and said, I am light.
Y Dios empezó a hablar a mí y me dijo, yo soy luz.
He said, so science isn't far off.
Entonces la ciencia no está tan lejos.
Because not only am I light,
porque no solamente soy luz,
but I'm life.
Pero soy vida.
So if you can ever get to me,
so si puedes llegar a mí,
you have eternal life.
Tienes vida eterna.
And I thought about it.
Y lo me puse a pensar.
Because scientists are operating in their gifting just outside the Word of God.
Porque los científicos están operando en sus dones y regalos fuera de Dios.
They're trying to figure out what His Word already reveals to us.
Y ellos quieren revelar lo que la palabra ya nos ha revelado.
That if we just get to Him,
que si llegamos a Él,
we'll live forever.
Viviremos por siempre.
Think about that.
If
light is the constant, the only constant in the universe,
que si la luz es lo único constante en el universo,
and all we want to do is we want to find life
through
this misery
and
these things that we're going through in our own life,
es buscar vida para salir de la vida miserable que tenemos.
All we have to do,
lo único que tenemos que hacer,
is step into His presence.
Es entrar a su presencia.
Fullness of joy, there's peace, there's joy,
hay gozo, paz.
Joy forevermore.
Gozo por siempre más.
In His presence.
En su presencia.
Because He's the one constant
thing. Porque
él
es la única cosa constante.
He is the light of the world.
Él es la luz del mundo.
Everything else is perishing and fading.
Todo lo demás está yendo.
But when you walk in the light.
Pero cuando tú caminas en la luz.
And you follow the light.
Y tú sigues la luz.
It illuminates your path, every step.
Ilumina cada paso.
And every path,
y cada camino,
straight to Him,
que llega a Él,
and you'll live forever.
Y vivirás por siempre.
And it just shocked me and blew my mind.
Y me hizo como un shock.
And if you really think about it,
y si en realidad lo piensas,
God wants to change each and every one of our lives tonight.
Dios quiere cambiar a cada uno de nosotros.
And He's prepared a word for us tonight.
Y ha preparado una palabra en esta noche.
And so we want to invite you tonight.
Entonces te queremos invitar en esta noche.
To get out of your seats.
A que salgas de tu lugar.
Say hello. Hello to your neighbor, somebody you may not know.
Dile hola a alguien que no conoces.
Greet our new guests and let them know we love them.
Dile a los que están aquí por primera vez que los amamos.
We appreciate you. And get ready for that word tonight. Amen.
God bless y'all. Prepárense para esa palabra. Dios les bendiga.
Welcome to the best place to be on a Sunday night. Come on, Revive Church.
Bienvenidos al mejor lugar por un domingo por la noche. Vamos, iglesia.
How many of you are excited to be in the house of the Lord tonight?
¿Cuántos están emocionados de estar en la casa de Dios?
Come on, put your hands together and give
Vamos,
God a
pon
praise.
Pon tus manos juntas y dale alabanza a Dios.
We're excited to have you here tonight.
Estamos emocionados de tenerlos en esta noche.
My name is Pastor Humberto.
Mi nombre es el Pastor Humberto.
And if you're visiting us here for the first time,
si nos estás visitando por primera vez,
our vision here at Revive,
la visión aquí en Revive,
is to lead people,
es de guiar a las personas,
to encounter God,
a encontrarse con Dios,
His presence,
su presencia,
and His power,
y su poder,
not just on Sundays,
no solamente los domingos,
every single day of your life.
pero todos los días de tu vida.
So you didn't come here just to get an awesome Sunday service.
No veniste nada más a tener una experiencia asombrosa.
We came here to encounter His presence.
Pero veniste a encontrarte con su presencia.
Say with me, Sundays.
Dilo conmigo, los domingos.
Are for Him.
Son para él.
Sundays.
Los domingos.
Are for Him.
Son para él.
And we can't wait to encounter God together.
Y estoy emocionado que vamos a encontrarlo a él juntos.
Because the Lord continues to move tonight.
Porque el Señor continúa moviéndose
so,
hoy.
So if this is your first time,
so, si es tu primera vez,
you might see a little card right in front of you,
a lo mejor
in front
hay una tarjetita
of one of your chairs.
Enfrente de tu silla.
You can grab your phone and take a quick picture of that.
Puedes agarrar tu teléfono
and
y tomar una foto.
You can connect with us right now.
Puedes conectarte con nosotros ahorita mismo.
Or after service, go visit our connections table.
O puedes visitarnos en nuestra mesa de
and meet some beautiful faces that we have there.
Y ver esas caras hermosas que
where
tenemos.
Are all my Revive Youth at? Come on, Revive
están
Youth.
Los jóvenes de Revive.
Give me a little whoop-whoop. Come on, Revive Youth. Where
a
y'all
ver,
at?
Jóvenes, ¿dónde están?
All right, listen. Tomorrow night, Revive Youth in the house.
Mañana en la noche,
right.
Aquí.
Right here at the Norris Center.
En el Norris Center.
7 p.m. tomorrow night.
A las 7 de la noche.
We want you to come and join us.
Queremos que vengas.
If you or you got a young person between the ages of 12 and I don't know, 30? No, I'm just kidding.
Si tienes a jóvenes de la edad de
12 and 18,
a 19 años,
sometimes we get some 30-year-olds popping
a veces llegan
in,
algunos
you know?
De 30 y que llegan de vez en
but you can text the number on the screen, 830-209-0808.
Pero pueden mandar un texto a esa palabra, ese
and,
número aquí.
You can meet us here tomorrow night at 7 p.m.
Y véanos aquí a las 7 de la noche mañana.
It's going to be an awesome night.
Va a ser una noche asombrosa.
All right. One, because I think I know who's preaching, right?
Una porque yo sé quién va a predicar mañana.
Miss Evelyn is preaching tomorrow night, y'all, so.
Evelyn estará predicando mañana.
The Lord put a word in her belly.
El Señor ha puesto una palabra en su
and she's going to release it tonight to you guys.
Y ella la va a predicar en esta noche. No, no estoy bromeando.
So be here tomorrow,
so
youth.
Estén aquí mañana, jóvenes.
And as Pastor Kyle already said,
y como dijo Pastor Kyle,
next Sunday is revival night.
El próximo domingo es noche de avivamiento.
We don't want you to miss that.
Y no queremos que se lo pierda.
It's going to be phenomenal.
Va a ser fenomenal.
All right, let's stand up to our feet. Let's go to the word of the Lord.
Vamos a ponernos de pie. Vamos
stretch
a entrar
those legs
palabra,
just a moment.
Estiren sus pies.
And I want you to go with me to the book of Genesis.
Y quiero que vayan conmigo al libro de Génesis.
Genesis chapter 1.
Génesis 1.
We all know this scripture already.
Todos sabemos esa escritura.
In the beginning,
en el principio,
God created
creó Dios,
the heavens and the earth.
Los cielos y la tierra.
The earth
y la tierra
was without form,
estaba desordenada,
void
y vacía,
and full of darkness.
Y las tinieblas.
And the darkness was on the face of the deep.
Estaban sobre la faz del abismo.
And the Spirit of God
y el Espíritu de Dios
was moving over the surface of the waters.
Se movía sobre la faz de las aguas.
Right, let's read verse 2 one more time. And
vamos
the earth
dos, y la tierra
was without form,
estaba desordenada,
void,
y vacía.
And everyone say, full of darkness.
Y todos digan, llenas de tinieblas.
Say it one more time, full of darkness.
Llena de tinieblas.
But the Spirit of God
dice, pero el Espíritu de Dios
was moving
se movía
over the face of the waters.
Sobre la faz de las aguas.
One more scripture, Isaiah chapter 45.
Vamos a ir a Isaías 45.
Isaiah chapter 45.
Isaías 45.
And verse 3.
Versículo 3.
And I will give you
y te daré
the treasures
los tesoros
of darkness
escondidos.
Let me read it one more time. And I will give you
y te daré
the treasures
los tesoros
of darkness
escondidos
and hidden wealth
y los secretos
of secret places
muy guardados.
So that you may know that it is I
para que sepas que yo soy
the Lord,
Jehová,
God of Israel,
el Dios de Israel,
who calls you by name,
que te pongo nombre,
and I will give you the treasures of darkness.
Y te daré los tesoros escondidos.
Everyone say, God
todos digan, Dios
is going to give me,
me dará
the treasures
los tesoros
of dark places,
de lugares escondidos.
For the next few minutes,
por los próximos minutos,
I want to take some time
quiero tomar un momento
and give you this prophetic word
y darte esta palabra profética
that I feel the Lord put on my heart
que el Señor puso en mi corazón.
And I want to title it tonight, Grow in the Dark.
Y quiero ponerle por nombre, Crece en
Everyone
en
say
la
with me, grow
crece
in the dark.
En la oscuridad.
Father, we bless your word.
Padre, bendecimos tu palabra.
Would you speak to us tonight?
Háblanos en esta noche.
In Jesus' mighty name.
En el nombre poderoso de
Jesús. You are the guest of honor, Lord.
Tú eres el visitante de honor.
And we thank you.
Y te damos las gracias.
That you would meet us right here.
Que tú nos encuentras aquí.
Now we ask that you would speak, Lord.
Ahora te pedimos que hables, Señor.
Your servants are listening.
Tus siervos escuchan.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de
amen,
Jesús.
Amen. 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 High five your neighbor. Tell him, grow
dale
in the dark. Grow in the dark.
Vecino, dile, crece en la oscuridad.
Grow in the dark.
Crece en la oscuridad.
Awesome. Y'all may be seated tonight.
Pueden tomar asiento.
Thank you, Ben.
Gracias, banda.
Grow in the dark.
Crece en la oscuridad.
You know, one of the things that each and every one of us cannot ever avoid.
Saben, una de las cosas que cada uno de nosotros no podemos detener.
No one is exempt from this.
Nadie es exento de esto.
And that is going through hard times.
Y eso es pasar por momentos difíciles.
Do I got anybody that's ever been through some stuff here tonight?
Alguien aquí que ha pasado por cosas difíciles, levanta tu mano.
Just lift up your hand. If you don't raise your hand right now, we pray for liars here too. So.
Si no levantas tu mano, oramos por mentirosos también.
If you said you've never been through something.
So si tú dices que nunca has pasado por algo.
Then you might be an angel. Angel, I don't know.
Sent
from heaven.
Que te mandaron del
but
cielo.
Each and every one of us,
pero cada uno de nosotros,
we all go through difficult moments.
Todos pasamos por momentos difíciles.
And one of the hardest seasons for us to go through,
y una de las temporadas más difíciles que pasamos,
is when you don't understand why you're going through it.
Es cuando no entiendes por qué lo estás pasando.
Has anybody ever been there in their lives?
¿Alguien ha estado ahí en su vida?
When you don't understand,
cuando no entendemos,
the dark space,
ese lugar oscuro,
or the dark moment,
o ese momento oscuro.
And what I love about God's word,
y lo que amo de la palabra de Dios,
is that since the beginning of time,
es que desde el principio de los tiempos,
the Bible says,
la palabra dice,
let's put Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1 up there one more time.
Vamos a poner Génesis 1:1 otra vez.
In the beginning, God created.
Dice, en el principio creó Dios.
And he created the heavens and the earth.
Dice que él creó los cielos y la tierra.
Everyone say with me, two dimensions.
Todos digan, dos dimensiones.
Say with me one more time, two dimensions.
Otra vez, dos dimensiones.
So he creates the heavenly dimension.
So él creó la dimensión celestial.
And then he creates the earthly dimension.
Y luego él crea la dimensión terrenal.
And then the Bible says,
y la Biblia dice,
that the earth,
que la tierra,
was formless.
Estaba desordenada.
It was void.
Estaba vacía.
And darkness was over the whole surface of the deep.
Y las tinieblas estaban sobre la faz del abismo.
Everyone say with me, void.
Todos digan, vacía,
formless,
desordenada,
and full of darkness.
Y llena de tinieblas.
Say it one more time, void.
Otra vez, vacía,
formless,
desordenada,
full of darkness.
Y llena de tinieblas.
Look at your neighbor, tell him, void.
Mira a tu vecino y le vacío,
formless,
desordenado,
and full of darkness.
Y lleno de tinieblas.
Doesn't this look like us before Jesus?
¿Eso no se ve como nosotros antes de Jesús?
Doesn't Genesis chapter 1 and verse 2 look like my life before I met Jesus?
¿No se ve Génesis 1 y 2 como mi vida antes de conocer a Jesús?
Void,
vacía,
in disorder,
desordenada,
formless,
sin forma,
and full of darkness.
Y llena de
tinieblas. There was no light in me.
No había vida en mí.
Because I had not had an encounter with Jesus.
Porque no había tenido un encuentro con Jesús.
I would pretend everything was great.
Yo actuaba como que todo estaba bien.
But deep down inside,
pero dentro de mí,
I knew I was void.
Yo sabía que estaba vacío.
Empty.
Vacío,
full of darkness.
Lleno de tinieblas.
And when Jesus,
y cuando Jesús,
encounters our lives,
se encuentra con nuestra vida,
suddenly there is a filling,
de repente hay una llenura,
that comes from his presence,
que viene de su presencia,
the presence that is full of joy,
la presencia que está llena de gozo.
But it's interesting to me,
y es interesante para mí,
that while the earth realm,
que en lo terrenal,
was in disorder.
Estaba en desorden.
The earth realm,
la tierra,
was void.
Estaba vacía.
The earth realm,
el ámbito terrenal,
was formless.
No tenía orden.
The earth realm,
la tierra,
was full of darkness.
Estaba llena de tinieblas.
Everyone say the earth.
Todos digan la tierra.
Say with me, the earth.
La tierra.
Notice that it does not say the heavens.
Miren que no dicen los cielos.
The heavens,
los cielos,
were in order.
Estaban en orden.
The heavens,
los cielos,
were full.
Estaban llenos.
The heavens,
los cielos,
were full of God's presence.
Estaban llenos de la
but
presencia
the
de
earth
Dios. Pero la tierra
was what was empty.
Era lo que estaba vacía.
And the Bible says
y la Biblia dice
that the Spirit of God
que el Espíritu de Dios
was still moving
se movía
over the surface of the waters.
Sobre la faz de las aguas.
What I love about the Scriptures
y lo que amo sobre las Escrituras
is that it does not matter the dark season that you may find yourself in.
Es que no importa la temporada de oscuridad que pases.
How many of you are thankful that God is still moving?
¿Cuántos de ustedes están agradecidos que Dios todavía se mueve?
Someone better shout it with me and just say, God
grítelo,
is still
diga,
moving.
Dios está moviendo.
God is still moving.
Dios todavía se mueve.
In other words, in the middle of your nothing,
significa que en medio de tu nada,
God is still getting ready to do something.
Dios todavía se prepara para hacer algo.
Just because you don't see it,
y solo porque no lo ves,
it doesn't mean God's not moving.
No significa que Dios no se está moviendo.
So I'm looking for the type of people,
so estoy buscando a la gente,
that may find themselves going into something,
que se encuentren ver cómo entran a algo,
coming out of something,
salen de algo,
or just got over something.
O a lo mejor acaban de pasar sobre
algo. Is anybody here with me?
Alguien está aquí.
I'm looking for the people,
estoy buscando a esa gente,
that are going into something,
que van a entrar a algo,
coming out of something,
están saliendo de
or
algo,
just got over
o
something.
Acaban de pasar por algo.
I'm looking for the people,
estoy buscando a la gente,
that even when you don't see it,
que aun cuando no lo ves,
you know God is still moving
tú
on your
sabes
behalf.
Que Dios está moviendo por ti.
There are treasures in dark places.
Hay tesoros escondidos.
That's why Isaiah chapter 45.
Y por eso en Isaías 45.
In verse 3.
45:3 él dice,
I will give you treasures of darkness.
Te daré los tesoros escondidos.
Now, I don't know about you.
Y no sé de ti.
But when I read something like this,
pero cuando yo leo algo así,
I'm like, God,
yo digo, Señor,
how am I going to see when it's dark?
¿Cómo voy a ver cuando está oscuro?
And how are you going to get treasures out of dark moments?
¿Y cómo vas a sacar tesoros de lugares oscuros?
It's almost as if God loves to put things in the dark.
Es como que si Dios le encanta poner cosas en la oscuridad.
Because it's in the dark moments.
Porque es en los momentos oscuros.
Where God brings things out of you that you didn't even know you
donde
had
Dios
in you.
Donde Dios saca cosas de ti que aún tú no sabías que tenías.
It's in the dark seasons of your life.
Es en las temporadas oscuras.
It's in the moments of absence.
Es en los momentos de ausencia.
It's in the moments where you feel void.
Es en los momentos que te sientes
it's
vacío.
In the moments where you feel empty.
Es en los momentos que te sientes vacío.
Where God says you're in the perfect moment for
cuando
me to
Dios
bring
dice,
out the treasure.
Estás en el mejor momento para yo sacar ese tesoro.
You're in the perfect moment.
Estás en el momento perfecto.
For me to bring out of you.
Para que yo saque de ti.
What's been hidden inside of you.
Lo que ha estado escondido dentro de ti.
But you've never seen it.
Pero tú nunca lo has visto.
Am I talking to anybody here tonight?
Te estoy hablando a alguien.
And the reason why the Lord wanted us to talk about this tonight.
Y la razón por la que Dios quería que habláramos de eso en esta noche.
Is because I'm looking for the right person here.
Es porque estoy buscando a la persona correcta.
And if I knew who it was.
Y si yo supiera quién es.
I would tell all of y'all to go down to the buffet.
Yo les diría que fueran al buffet.
And go enjoy yourselves right now.
Y que pues se la pasaran bien.
But because I don't know who that person is.
Pero porque no sé quién es esa persona.
All of y'all got to stay and hear me preach.
Ahora todos tienen que estar aquí y escuchar la palabra.
I'm just kidding.
No estoy bromeando.
But it's for all of us.
Que es para todos.
The Bible says
la Biblia dice
that there are treasures in dark places.
Que hay tesoros en lugares escondidos.
And it's almost like the dark space.
Y es como que el lugar oscuro.
It's the place, Evelyn.
Es el lugar, Evelyn.
It's the place in between.
Es en el lugar entre medio.
It's the place in between the inception.
Es el lugar entre medio de la incepción.
And the development.
Y lo que se va haciendo.
In other words, it's the place between when it started.
Es cuando comienza.
And when it finished.
Y cuando termina.
You know, all of us love to celebrate things that just got started.
A todos nos encanta celebrar cosas que acaban de comenzar.
You just got started in a new job.
A lo mejor acabas de comenzar un nuevo trabajo.
And we celebrate those things.
Y celebramos eso.
You got a new man.
Te agarraste un hombre nuevo.
You celebrate that thing.
Y celebramos eso.
You got a new woman.
Agarraste una mujer nueva.
Not the married folks, but the
no
single
los casados,
folks.
Right? Los solteros.
Y'all
solteros.
Still trying to get it together, all right? But you get a new relationship.
Pero tienes una nueva relación.
And you celebrate it.
Y lo celebras.
You find a new church.
Encuentras una nueva iglesia. Y lo celebras.
You get a new pastor.
Un nuevo pastor.
And you just love him. You want to stay here.
Y lo amas y lo que te quieres quedar.
That's what we're hoping for, all right?
Es lo que esperamos.
Thank you, thank you. So, whenever we celebrate things that just get started.
Celebramos las cosas que acaban de comenzar.
And then we're fanatics, y'all.
Y somos fanáticos.
We over-celebrate.
O sea, sobre-celebramos.
When things get finished.
Cuando las cosas están terminadas.
Your little three-year-old son graduated from preschool.
El niño
oh, my
se graduó
gosh.
De preschool.
Woo! put a cap and gown on the
le
kid.
Le pones su gorrita.
Take photos.
Le tomas fotos.
He graduated from preschool.
Se graduó de preschool.
Hasn't started kindergarten.
No ha ni comenzado kinder.
But it's worth celebrating.
Pero se merece
celebrar. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
¿Alguien sabe de lo que hablo?
All right. We celebrate graduations.
Celebramos las graduaciones.
Because it's a celebration of something that finished.
Porque es una celebración right. de algo que terminó.
We celebrate these moments.
Celebramos estos momentos.
Because we're excited.
Porque estamos emocionados.
When things start.
Cuando las cosas comienzan.
We're even more excited.
Y estamos más emocionados.
When things finish.
Cuando las cosas terminan.
But none of us ever talk about the place in between.
Pero nadie habla de lo de en medio.
We don't often talk about
no hablamos
the process
del proceso
that took me from my story to the glory.
Que me llevó de la historia a la gloria.
Because if you would understand the process,
porque si tú entenderías el proceso,
it's the space in between
es el espacio entre medio
where I want to throw in the towel.
Donde quiero tirar la toalla.
It's the space in between.
Es el espacio entre medio.
It's what God does in the dark.
Es lo que Dios hace en la oscuridad.
When I don't see what he's trying to do with me.
Cuando no veo lo que él quiere hacer conmigo.
And you have to understand that things are developed in the dark.
Y tienes que entender que las cosas son desarrolladas en la oscuridad.
In the old times, in the old, you know, old seasons, maybe around Evelyn's age or something.
En la temporada vieja, así como la edad de Evelyn.
Maybe Kyle's age.
Right? O a lo mejor como la de Kyle.
They used to have these photos.
Tenían esas fotos.
And they would go into a dark room.
Iban a un cuarto oscuro.
Because if you would want to see that photo,
porque si querías ver esa foto,
the photo could only be developed
la foto solamente se podía ser desarrollada
in the dark.
En la oscuridad.
If the photo was exposed to too much light, you
si
could... You could
si la
ruin the photo.
Fuera expuesta a mucha luz, se podía arruinar la foto.
If you would expose it to too much light,
si tú la exponías a mucha luz,
you could destroy the photo.
Podías destruir la foto.
So if you're going to get the best image
entonces, si vas a agarrar la mejor imagen,
and the best quality
y la mejor calidad
of that photo,
de esa fotografía,
it has to be developed in the dark.
Tenía que ser desarrollada en lo oscuro.
But what we don't see
pero lo que no vemos,
is that it's while in the dark place
es que es en el lugar oscuro,
that it's preparing you for the light.
Lo que te está preparando para la luz.
Sometimes some of us want too much spotlight without the development.
A veces muchos queremos mucha luz sin ser desarrollados.
Without knowing that it's the light that can destroy
sin saber que la luz es lo que te puede destruir.
So sometimes God has to keep you hidden.
Entonces a veces Dios se tiene que mantener escondido.
God has to keep you a mystery.
Dios se tiene que mantener un
misterio. Does anybody know what I'm talking about?
¿Alguien sabe de lo que estoy hablando?
God has to keep you hidden.
Dios se tiene que mantener escondido.
Not for your rejection.
No para tu rechazo.
But for your protection.
Pero para por tu protección.
And sometimes we don't understand God's protection.
Y a veces no entendemos la protección de Dios.
Because we think that God's rejection.
Porque pensamos que el rechazo de Dios.
Let me back up. We think that man's rejection
pensamos que el rechazo del hombre
was also God's rejection.
También fue el rechazo de Dios.
When in actuality,
pero en actualidad,
if Joseph would have known
si José hubiera sabido
that the rejection of his brothers
que el rechazo de sus hermanos
was actually direction to a palace.
Fue una dirección a un palacio.
Are y'all getting what I'm saying?
¿Están escuchando lo
that
que estoy
when Joseph
diciendo?
Found himself in a dark pit,
que cuando José estuvo en el hoyo,
I came to talk to some Josephs
yo le vine
here tonight.
A hablar a unos Josés en esta noche,
the dreamers,
los soñadores,
the ones that have been asking God,
los que
God, show me
diciendo
more.
A Dios, Señor, muéstrame más.
I'm speaking to the visionaries here tonight.
A los visionarios.
The ones that still got dreams and
aquellos
visions.
Que todavía sueñan y tienen visiones.
That know that just because it seems dark, it means God's not moving.
Que saben que aunque esté oscuro, Dios no deja de moverse.
It doesn't mean God's not moving.
No significa que Dios dejó de moverse.
But baby, if the pit doesn't look like the dream,
pero si el hoyo no se ve como el sueño,
then the pit is only temporary.
Entonces el hoyo es solo temporal.
Someone look at your neighbor and tell them it's temporary.
Alguien ve a su vecino y dile es temporal.
Tell him stop crying. It's
dile,
temporary.
Deja de llorar. Es temporal.
Turn to the one you don't like. Tell him it's temporal.
Mira al que no te cae bien y dile es temporal.
If the pit don't look like the dream,
si el hoyo no se ve como el sueño,
then that means that the dark space is only temporary.
Entonces significa que el lugar oscuro solo es temporal.
Because no matter where you put Joseph,
porque no importa dónde pones a José,
Joseph was going to rise.
José se levantaba.
Joseph was put in a pit.
José fue puesto en el hoyo.
And he got out.
Y salió.
He was put in a one-way Uber all the way from
lo pusieron
the way to
en
Egypt.
Un Uber de directo a Egipto.
Directly to Egypt.
Directo a Egipto.
And no matter where you put Joseph,
y no importaba dónde lo pusieras,
he was going to rise.
Él se iba a levantar.
Put him in the prison.
Lo pusieron en la prisión.
He was going to rise.
Él se iba a levantar.
Put him in the pit.
Lo pusieron en el hoyo.
He was going to rise.
Él se iba a levantar.
I don't know who I'm talking to tonight,
no sé,
but some of y'all got to understand.
Pero
no matter where they put you, you're going to rise
te pongan,
up.
Tú te vas a levantar.
Put me wherever you want to put me, Pastor.
Ponme donde me quieras poner, Pastor.
I promise I'll rise.
Yo te prometo que me levantaré.
It's the attitude that you need to start having.
Es la actitud que tienes que tener.
But I know some of y'all too bougie for all that.
Pero
right?
Yo sé que algunos son muy bougie para
nah, if it ain't on my job description, I
si
ain't
no
gonna
está
do
en
it.
Mi descripción de trabajo, no lo voy a hacer.
Where's my job description?
¿Dónde está mi descripción de trabajo?
I'm just gonna get in trouble right now.
Me voy a meter en problemas.
Let me move on to my notes.
Okay, voy a mover a mis notas.
It's important for us to understand.
Es importante que sepamos
that God develops us in the dark.
Que Dios nos desarrolla en la oscuridad.
And don't misinterpret a dark moment.
Y no leas las cosas en la oscuridad mal.
Thinking that a moment is forever.
Pensando que un momento es para siempre.
You want to know why?
¿Sabes por qué?
Because some of us make eternal decisions based on temporary circumstances.
Porque algunos tomamos decisiones eternales en cosas temporales.
Some of us make eternal decisions.
Algunos tomamos decisiones eternales
based on a temporary moment of time.
Basado en un momento temporal del tiempo.
And you think that that moment was forever.
Y tú crees que ese tiempo fue para siempre.
But the Lord develops us in the dark.
Pero el Señor nos desarrolla en la oscuridad.
Because he unlocks things in us.
Porque él empieza a abrir cosas dentro de nosotros.
That no one can see.
Que nadie puede ver.
And God is always working.
Y Dios siempre está trabajando.
And I want to tell someone tonight.
Y yo le quiero decir a alguien
that even though the earth
que aunque la tierra
was void, empty,
estaba
and full
vacía
of darkness,
y llena de oscuridad,
it doesn't mean that God wasn't moving.
No significa que Dios no se estaba moviendo.
And I'm looking for someone here tonight
y estoy buscando a alguien en
that
esta
needs
noche
to grab this in their spirit.
Que necesita en su espíritu.
Just because it surprised you
no solamente porque te sorprendió,
does not mean it surprised God.
No significa que sorprendió a Dios.
Just because it caught you off guard
a lo mejor te sacó fuera de tu serie,
doesn't mean it caught God off guard.
No sacó a Dios de su lugar.
It may have surprised you.
A lo mejor te sorprendió a ti.
But baby, everything is working out for your good.
Pero todo está trabajando por tu bien.
Somebody needs to get up on their feet and shout, it's working for my good.
Decir, todo trabaja por mi bien.
I may not see it.
A lo mejor no lo veo.
I may not know how it's going to work.
No sé cómo va a funcionar.
But all I know is that whatever was formed against me,
pero yo sé que lo que era en contra de
it
mí,
can't prosper against
no
me.
No puede prosperar en contra
because
de
it's
mí.
Working for my good.
Porque está trabajando por mi bien.
Even my dark moments work out for my good.
Aún mis momentos difíciles.
Even bad relationships work out for my good.
Relaciones malas son para mi bien.
Even the denial works out for my good.
El rechazo es para mi bien.
Some of y'all got to understand.
Algunos tienen que entender.
That's why I don't bow.
Pero es que yo me postro
to a temporary moment.
A un momento temporal.
I can feel the rejection.
Yo puedo ver el rechazo.
And it hurts.
Y me duele.
I can feel the denial.
Yo puedo ver cuando me dicen que
and
no.
And it hurts.
Y me duele.
I can feel the moment of pain.
Yo puedo sentir el momento de dolor.
And it hurts.
Y me duele.
But there comes a point in your relationship with God.
Pero llega un momento con tu relación con Dios.
Where you and I know that we are sons and daughters of a King.
Donde tú y yo sabemos que somos hijos y hijas de un Dios.
And if I am His son.
Y si yo soy una
and
hija,
if Evelyn is his
si
daughter,
yo soy un hijo, y
then no
mi
matter
Dios,
what works up against me,
no importa que venga en contra
it's
de mí,
all going to work for my good.
Mi bien.
So you can reject me.
Me
you,
puedes rechazar,
you can leave me.
Me puedes dejar,
you can try to work up against me.
Puedes venir en contra de mí.
It's going to work out for my good.
Todo va a ser para mi bien.
It's going to work out for my somebody. Oh, I feel that one.
Vamos.
Someone just shout, it's going to work for my good.
Alguien grite, va a ser por mi
it's
bien.
Going to work for my good.
Va a trabajar por mi bien.
I may not see it because I'm in a dark
a lo mejor
space.
No lo veo porque estoy en un lugar oscuro.
But I know I wasn't buried.
Pero yo sé que no fui
enterrado. I know that I was planted.
Yo sé que fui plantado.
Amen.
Amen.
There's seasons of our lives.
Hay temporadas en nuestra vida.
That look dark.
Que se ven oscuras.
But hear me, darkness.
Pero escúchenme,
is
la oscuridad.
Not a thing.
No es una cosa.
It's an absence of a thing.
Es una ausencia de una cosa.
Absence.
La ausencia.
Darkness.
la oscuridad
is only the absence
solamente la ausencia
of what really exists.
De lo que en realidad existe.
So when you go through dark moments of your life,
so cuando pasas por momentos oscuros en tu vida,
where you don't understand the why you're going through,
cuando
it,
no entiendes el por qué estás pasando,
am I still talking to the right people?
Le estoy hablando a la gente correcta?
When you're going through something,
cuando estás pasando por algo,
and you don't know why,
y no sabes por qué,
you went through it.
¿Por qué lo pasaste?
You don't know why,
no sabes por
you
qué,
you entered into it.
Entraste en eso.
You don't know why,
no sabes por
you
qué,
you had to go through that specific process.
Tuviste que pasar por ese proceso.
It almost seems like, I don't know if I'm talking to the right people,
no
but
si
it almost seems like
correcta.
Other people have it easy
pero
and I just
que
have it
todos
hard.
Los demás lo tienen bien, y yo no.
Why does things seem easy for them?
Porque se ve fácil para ellos.
But seems so difficult for me.
Pero se ve difícil para mí.
Because you're developed in the dark.
Porque tú estás siendo desarrollado en la
what
oscuridad.
Elevated them could eliminate you.
Lo que los elevó a ellos se puede eliminar a ti.
I didn't catch that one. What elevated them
lo que los elevó a ellos
could have eliminated you.
Te pudo haber eliminado a ti.
Because if you don't allow your character to be developed in the dark space,
porque si tú no permites que tu carácter sea desarrollado en el lugar oscuro,
your elevation
tu elevación
could actually be your elimination if you don't have the character to sustain it. Amen. It's so important for us
es tan importante
to allow the processes of God
que permitamos que los procesos de Dios
to be fulfilled in our lives.
Sean llenos en nuestra vida.
It's almost as if some of us want to grow in the dark.
Es como que si algunos quisiéramos crecer en la oscuridad.
But the funny thing,
pero lo chistoso,
right now,
es que ahorita,
the question would be,
la pregunta sería,
answer with me.
Y contéstenme.
Is Evelyn growing right now?
Evelyn está creciendo ahorita?
Is she growing?
Está creciendo?
Respond.
Responda.
Yes.
Sí.
For real, she's growing.
¿De veras está creciendo?
I don't see her growing.
Yo no la veo creciendo.
But even in the moment that I don't see it,
pero aún en los momentos que no lo veo,
I know things are growing.
Yo sé que hay cosas que están
right?
creciendo.
Her hair's growing.
El pelo le está creciendo.
Her nails are growing.
Sus uñas están creciendo.
I'm gonna keep it. Don't worry. We'll keep it pure. All right.
Thank you, Pastor.
Her feet might be growing, I don't know.
A lo mejor los pies están creciendo.
But things are growing.
Pero las cosas están creciendo.
But it's so minute.
Pero son cosas tan minutas.
It's so small.
Tan pequeñas.
That you can't see the growth.
Que no puedes ver el crecimiento.
In the moment.
En el momento.
But if you give it enough time.
Pero si le das tiempo.
You'll see that her hair grew.
Vas a ver que su pelo creció.
Those nails grew
las
or whatever.
Le crecieron, lo
but
que
if,
sea.
I, if I get my 3-year-old son.
Pero si yo agarro a mi niño de 3 años.
Who's about 3 feet tall.
Que es como de 3 pies.
Almost there.
Casi, casi.
Right? And if I see my son today,
y si ve a mi hijo ahora,
and tomorrow,
y mañana,
my 3-year-old son
mi hijo,
is 6'3".
De repente es 6'3".
What am I going to think?
¿Qué voy a pensar?
What in the world just happened to my son?
¿Qué le pasó a mi hijo?
Because I know
porque yo sé
that type of growth
que ese tipo de crecimiento
is abnormal.
Es abnormal.
And you cannot microwave your relationship with God.
Y no puedes tener una relación de microonda con Dios.
I can't put you in a microwave.
No te puedo poner en un microonda.
Shut the door.
Cerrar la puerta.
Put you in the dark.
Ponerte en la oscuridad.
Put you for 30 seconds.
Ponle 30 segundos.
And expect you to come out popping.
Y esperar que salgas de ahí.
Not even your kernel will come out popping after 30 seconds. Come on. Ni tu kernel.
Ni tu kernel. Ni tu mazorca estará.
Yeah. Whatever you want to call it. You can't even put a popcorn bag inside
no
a microwave.
No vas a poner ni una bolsa de popcorn.
For 30
de
seconds.
De palomitas por 30 segundos.
And all you're going to eat is a bunch of crunchy kernels.
Y lo único que vas a comer son cosas duras.
But some of y'all want to be developed in a microwave.
Pero algunos de ustedes quieren ser desarrollados en el microondas.
Not understanding that you're best treasures
sin entender que tus mejores tesoros
are in your dark moments.
Son en tus lugares oscuros.
Some of y'all got to learn to start praising God for dark seasons.
Algunos tienen que aprender a adorar en esas temporadas de oscuridad.
The moments when you don't understand why he's doing it.
Cuando tú no entiendes por qué él lo está haciendo.
Why are you doing it for others but you ain't doing it for me?
¿Por qué lo haces por otros pero no lo haces por mí?
Why does it seem like they're elevating?
¿Por qué parece que los estás elevando a ellos?
And I'm going down.
Y yo voy para abajo.
Because there's a development process.
Porque hay un tiempo de desarrollo.
Where you learn to grow in dark moments.
Donde aprendes a crecer en lugares oscuros.
Avoid
un vacío,
an emptiness,
un lugar vacío,
is only the result
es solamente el resultado
when there's a lack of light.
Cuando falta la luz.
Kyle just said it earlier.
Kyle lo dijo temprano.
That his word,
que su palabra,
is the light.
Es la luz.
His word,
su palabra,
it is the light.
Es la luz.
And in Genesis chapter 1,
y en Génesis 1,
verse 2,
dos,
the earth was void, empty, and full of darkness.
Dice que la tierra estaba vacía y llena de oscuridad.
But in verse 3,
pero en el versículo 3,
you don't ever see God rebuke the darkness.
No ves que Dios reprende la oscuridad.
You don't see God praying against the darkness.
No ves que Dios ora en contra de la oscuridad.
You don't see God,
no ves a Dios,
speaking in tongues against the darkness.
Hablando en lenguas en contra de la oscuridad.
This is going to kill your fattened calf right now.
Y eso te va a matar.
La vaca sagrada que tienes. All right? Imagine you go home.
Imagínate que vas a casa.
And you get to your home.
Y llegas a tu casa.
Everything's dark.
Y todo está oscuro.
And you walk into your house.
Y entras a tu casa.
And you look around.
Y miras hacia alrededor.
And everything's just dark.
Y todo está oscuro.
And you just hear Milo in his little car. Right?
Y escuchas a Milo.
You go into your home.
Y vas a tu casa.
I don't know if any of y'all do this.
Y no sé si algunos de ustedes hacen esto.
But everything's dark.
Pero todo está oscuro.
And suddenly you're like, Sotoro,
y de repente dice,
Lord, I come against every
Señor,
spirit of darkness in my house.
En mi casa.
I declare and decree,
yo
Lord, that all this darkness,
que
Lord,
toda esta oscuridad,
will
Señor,
come out of my house
saldrá de mi casa.
Now in Jesus' name.
Ahorita en el nombre de Jesús.
And here comes your little
y ahorita, y ahí viene tu,
four-year-old boy.
Tu niño de como cuatro años.
And he goes and he
goes.
It turns on the switch.
Y le prenden la...
And suddenly what you were praying against
y de repente, de lo que tú estabas orando,
is gone in a moment.
Se va en un momento.
Just because you brought in the light.
Porque llegó la luz.
Many of us,
muchos de nosotros,
are trying to rebuke things,
queremos reprender cosas,
when it's only the absence of the light.
Cuando es ausencia de la luz.
Some of y'all are only in dark seasons.
Algunos de ustedes están en temporadas oscuras.
Because there's an absence of a word.
Porque hay una ausencia de una palabra.
Some of us get stuck and stagnant.
Algunos de nosotros nos quedamos parados.
Just because you're in an absence of a word.
Solamente porque estás ausente de una palabra.
Did you know that one word from God?
¿Tú sabes que una palabra de Dios
can literally shift everything in your
literalmente
life.
Puede mover todo en tu vida.
So while you're in a stuck place,
o sea, mientras que tú estás atorado,
when you're in a low place,
cuando estás en un lugar bajo,
and when you're in a dark place,
y cuando estás en un lugar oscuro,
you don't got to rebuke the devil.
No tienes que reprender al diablo.
Just bring in the light.
Solamente trae la luz.
Bring in the light.
Trae la luz.
Someone say, let your light in God. Let
alguien
your light
diga,
in God.
Señor, que tu luz,
let your light
que tu
in
luz
God.
Entre.
That's why you get into the word of God.
Por eso entras a la palabra de Dios.
Because faith comes by what?
Porque la fe viene por
by hearing,
por el oír,
and hearing,
y el oír,
la comadre, no,
por la comadre, no.
Faith comes by hearing,
la fe viene por el oír,
and hearing what,
y el oír qué,
Telemundo, no. Faith comes by hearing,
la fe viene por el oír,
and hearing what,
y el oír qué,
Primer Impacto, no. Some of y'all don't know what Primer Impacto is.
Algunos de ustedes no saben qué es.
Don't worry, Kyle, we'll get
no
it.
No se preocupen.
Univision. No.
No.
Faith comes by
Univision.
Hearing.
It comes by hearing.
And by hearing.
Por el escuchar.
You're in Spanish.
Sorry,
I'm in English.
Yeah, sorry.
And by hearing.
Y por el escuchar.
The word of God.
La palabra de Dios.
It's his word.
Es su palabra.
That comes.
Que viene.
His word.
Su palabra.
That comes.
Viene.
And it brings faith with it.
Y trae fe con ella.
That's why,
por eso,
when you hear the word,
cuando tú escuchas la palabra,
and you have ears,
y tú tienes oídos,
faith runs,
la fe corre,
wherever the word is being spoken,
a donde la palabra está siendo hablada.
And if you got ears tonight
y si
to
tú
hear,
tienes oídos hoy,
then you're going to come out of this room full of faith,
salir de este cuarto
full
lleno
of
de
belief,
fe, lleno de creer,
full of faith,
lleno de fe.
Anything is possible for
todo
my God.
Es posible para mí, Dios.
All things will work out for my
todo
good for those that love
por
God.
Mi bien.
For nothing shall come against
porque
me.
Nada vendrá en contra de
everything
mí.
Form against me won't prosper.
Todo lo que venga contra mí no prosperará.
You come out with faith.
Sales con fe.
Knowing that I'm more than a conqueror.
Sabiendo que eres más que un conquistador.
So faith comes.
Entonces
faith,
la fe viene.
Faith comes.
La fe viene.
When you hear the word of God.
Cuando escuchas la palabra de Dios.
Much of your lack of faith.
Y muchos de falta de fe.
It's because you're not hearing right.
Es porque no están escuchando bien.
And when you're not hearing right.
Y cuando no escuchas bien.
You're not seeing right.
No ves.
Let me repeat it one more time.
Voy a repetirlo.
When you're not hearing right,
cuando no escuchas bien,
you're not seeing right,
no ves bien.
Everyone close your eyes for
todos
just a
cierren
moment.
Los ojos por un
just
momento.
Close your eyes.
Cierren los ojos.
I want you to see what I say.
Quiero que vean lo que yo digo.
Pink.
Rosado.
Horse.
Caballo.
With two brown boots.
Con dos botas cafés.
Drinking.
Tomando.
Some coffee.
Café.
Open your eyes.
Abran los ojos.
Why are y'all laughing?
Porque se ríen.
Because you saw it.
Porque lo vieron.
Did you notice that you saw it?
Se dieron cuenta que lo vieron.
Without your eyes open.
Sin los ojos abiertos.
Because your seeing.
Porque están viendo.
Has to do with your hearing.
Tiene mucho que ver con el oír.
And if you hear his voice.
Y si tú escuchas su voz.
If you hear his voice.
Si tú escuchas su voz.
If you hear his word.
Si tú escuchas su voz.
It'll change everything you see.
Cambiará todo lo que tú ves.
The problem is.
El problema es.
That you have sight.
Que tienes vista.
But you don't have vision.
Pero no tienes visión.
The greatest enemy to your vision,
el enemigo más grande a tu visión,
is going to be your own sight.
Va a ser tu vista.
So if you change your sight,
so si tú cambias tu vista,
you'll change your vision.
Tú vas a cambiar tu visión.
If you learn to begin to see with your eyes closed,
si tú aprendes a ver con los ojos cerrados,
you'll begin to see things that eye has not seen nor ear has heard.
Empezarás a ver cosas que ojos no han visto y oídos no han oído.
The things that God has prepared for those that love him.
Las cosas que Dios ha preparado para aquellos
it's
que lo aman.
It's because we're developed in the dark.
Es porque estamos desarrollados en la oscuridad.
It's the season of preparation for
us. Es la
us.
Temporada de preparación para nosotros.
And God does some of his best work in the dark.
Y Dios hace su mejor trabajo en lo oscuro.
Did you know that you began in the dark?
¿Sabes que tú comenzaste en la oscuridad?
Your life began in the dark.
Tu vida comenzó en la oscuridad.
Before God ever wants to bring a baby into a world.
Antes de que Dios quiera traer un bebé al mundo.
He puts that embryo and that seed inside a dark room.
Él pone esa semilla en un lugar oscuro.
And he puts it in a womb.
Y lo pone en un
because it's only in the womb.
Porque solamente en el vientre
that it can be developed.
Que puede ser desarrollado.
If that seed
y si esa semilla
is exposed to the light
es expuesta a la luz
before its time,
antes de su tiempo,
if it's exposed to an environment
si está expuesto a un ambiente
before its time,
antes de su tiempo,
the environment can actually destroy the embryo.
El ambiente puede matar el embrión.
That's why it's so important.
Por eso es tan importante
for each and every one of us
que cada uno de nosotros
to be developed.
Que seamos desarrollados.
Even in dark moments.
Aún en momentos oscuros.
You know, I'm reminded
y me recuerdo
that last Sunday we just celebrated the resurrection of Jesus.
Que el domingo pasado celebramos la resurrección de Cristo.
It was Resurrection Sunday.
Fue domingo de resurrección.
And we always preach on Friday night.
Y siempre predicamos el viernes.
Oh, gloomy Friday, right?
El viernes triste.
Is that gloomy Friday?
Viernes muy triste.
We saw crisis.
Vimos crisis.
We see Jesus dying.
Vemos a Jesús muriendo.
And then we come to church and we celebrate Sunday.
Y luego venimos el domingo y lo celebramos.
Because he rose again.
Porque él se levantó.
And he got up from the grave.
Él se levantó.
And he left our sins in the tomb.
Y él dejó nuestros pecados
and
en la tumba.
And he came up.
Y él salió.
With all power and authority.
Con todo poder y autoridad.
But we don't really preach on Saturday.
Pero no predicamos el sábado.
Because Saturday was the space in between.
Porque el sábado fue el espacio entre medio.
We celebrate the going in.
Celebramos cuando él entró.
And we celebrate the coming out.
Y celebramos la salida.
But half the church don't even know what happened on Saturday.
Pero la mitad de la iglesia no sabe ni lo que pasó el sábado.
Because it was in the dark moment.
Porque fue en ese momento de oscuridad.
Where Jesus,
cuando Jesús,
his body was in the tomb.
Su cuerpo estaba en la tumba.
But his spirit was not in the tomb.
Pero su espíritu no estaba en la tumba.
Hear me, church.
Escúchame, iglesia.
The Bible says,
la Biblia dice,
to be absent from the body,
que el estar ausente del cuerpo,
is to be present with the Lord.
Es estar presente ante Dios.
To be absent from the body,
estar ausente del cuerpo,
is to be present with the Lord.
Es estar presente ante el Señor.
That's for a believer.
Eso es para un creyente.
That's for someone that believes.
Eso es para alguien que cree.
When you believe in Jesus Christ,
cuando tú crees en Cristo Jesús,
your body will go down,
tu cuerpo irá ahí abajo,
but your spirit will be present with the Lord.
Pero tu espíritu estará presente ante Dios.
That is what we believe by faith.
Eso es lo que creemos por fe.
But the problem is this.
Pero el problema es este.
That's for a believer.
Eso es para un creyente.
But Jesus,
pero Jesús,
didn't die,
no murió,
as a believer,
como un creyente.
He died with the sin of humanity.
Él murió con el pecado del
so
mundo.
To be absent from the body
so estar ausente del cuerpo
is to be present with the Lord for a believer.
Es estar presente ante el Señor para un creyente.
Then for a sinner?
¿Y para un pecador?
What does it mean?
¿Qué significa?
It means that Jesus took on the sins of humanity.
Significa que Jesús tomó el pecado de la humanidad.
And on the dark Saturday.
Y en ese sábado oscuro.
On the silent Saturday.
En el sábado silencioso.
Jesus was still moving.
Jesús todavía se estaba moviendo.
You see, while we're just out here waiting to see what's going to happen.
Mientras que nosotros estamos aquí esperando a ver qué va a pasar.
It does not stop God from moving.
No para a Dios de moverse.
And even when things pause for you.
Y cuando aún las cosas se pausan para ti.
Even when things pause for you.
Cuando las cosas pausan para ti.
It doesn't make God stop his hand from moving.
Que Dios para.
How many of y'all are thankful that God still moves on our behalf?
Le dan gracias a Dios que él todavía se mueve.
Even when something paused me, it doesn't pause
me pausó
God.
A mí, no pausa a Dios.
And so, Jesus
Entonces, Jesús
is crucified,
es crucificado,
thrown in a tomb,
lo ponen en una tumba,
but he's still moving.
Pero él se está moviendo.
We know,
y nosotros sabemos,
it will take me some time to theologically,
que teológicamente
hermeneutically,
bíblicamente, cronológicamente.
Take the exegesis
toma el éxodo de Jesús
of understanding this mystery.
Y este misterio para poder entenderlo.
That Jesus went down to the pit of hell.
Que Jesús fue hasta el infierno.
Not because he was sent there.
No porque fue mandado.
Forever.
Por siempre.
But to take the keys of eternal life back.
Pero para tomar las llaves de la vida.
From the enemy.
Del enemigo.
And leave your sin there.
Y dejó tu pecado ahí.
The sins that you and I hadn't even committed yet.
El pecado que tú y yo no habíamos ni hecho.
The sins that you and I haven't even done yet.
El pecado que tú y yo no habíamos hecho todavía.
And yet Jesus already paid the price for it.
Y Jesús ya había pagado el precio.
He goes down to the pit of hell.
Él va al infierno.
He takes the keys of eternal life.
Él toma las llaves de la vida
rips
eterna.
Rips it out. From the hand of the enemy.
Las quita de las manos del enemigo.
He resurrects at the third day.
Y él resucita el tercer día.
And this is what I love about the scripture.
Es lo que me encanta de la escritura.
Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5.
En Isaías 53.
Put it on the screen. It says, He was pierced for our transgressions, and he was crushed for our iniquities.
Dice, mas el herido fue por nuestras rebeliones, molido por nuestros pecados, el castigo de nuestra paz fue sobre él.
He was wounded.
Él fue herido
for our transgressions.
Por nuestras rebeliones.
The version we have, he was pierced for our transgressions, but he was wounded for our transgressions.
Él fue herido por nuestras rebeliones.
Everyone say transgressions.
Todos digan rebeliones.
Say with me transgressions.
Todos digan rebeliones.
But he was bruised.
Dice, pero fue molido.
Or he was crushed.
Fue molido
for our iniquities.
Por nuestros pecados.
I want you to understand something, church.
Quiero que entiendan algo, iglesia.
That transgressions
que la transgresión
are the things that people see.
Son las cosas que la gente ve.
When we see sin,
cuando vemos el pecado,
that's your transgression.
Esa es tu transgresión.
Those are your sins.
Esos son tus pecados.
The stuff we get to see.
Las cosas que podemos ver.
It's the stuff I got myself into.
Son las cosas que yo me metí.
It's the stuff that I chose to do.
Cosas que yo decidí hacer.
And it's my transgressions.
Esas son mis transgresiones.
And he was pierced.
Y él fue herido.
Externally.
Externamente.
For your transgressions.
Por tus rebeliones.
When we talk about transgressions,
cuando hablamos de eso,
I just want to say it as simply as I can.
Lo voy a decir lo más simple que puedo.
The transgressions
las transgresiones
are the stuff
son las cosas
you can see from the outside.
Que se pueden ver de afuera.
But then there's stuff that happen on the inside.
Pero luego hay cosas que pasan por dentro.
The stuff I don't know why I go through.
Que cosas que no sé por qué las paso.
The stuff that I go through on the inside.
Las cosas que yo paso por dentro.
That is a result of my father and my forefather and my grandfather.
Que son resultados de mi padre y de mi abuelo y de mi bisabuelo.
There's stuff that you gotta fight through.
Cosas que tú tienes que pelear.
There's stuff that you gotta conquer.
Hay cosas que tú tienes que conquistar.
Because your own father or grandfather didn't want to conquer.
Porque tu abuelo o tu bisabuelo no quisieron conquistarlo.
And that goes from transgression to iniquity.
Y eso va de transgresión a iniquidad.
I'm going somewhere. Follow me.
Y voy a algún lado.
So the transgressions.
So la transgresión.
Are the external stuff.
Son las cosas externas.
The stuff people get to see.
Las cosas que la gente
the
puede
stuff
ver.
That gets exposed.
Lo que es expuesto.
The stuff that is on the outside.
Lo que está por fuera.
So he was wounded.
So él fue herido.
He was pierced.
Él fue lastimado.
For the stuff people get to see.
Por las cosas que la gente puede
but
ver.
But he was crushed.
Pero él fue molido.
Or he was bruised.
Fue molido.
For the stuff on the inside.
Por las cosas de adentro.
That people don't really know about.
Que la gente no sabe.
In other words.
De en otras palabras.
The secret stuff.
Las cosas secretas.
The dark stuff.
Las cosas oscuras.
The stuff on the inside.
Las cosas de adentro.
When he was pierced.
Cuando él fue herido.
He was pierced from the outside.
Él fue herido por afuera.
But if he's crushed.
Pero si él fue molido.
Or if he's bruised.
Si él fue molido.
He's bruised from the inside.
Es molido por dentro.
When you get a bruise on your arm,
cuando te sale un,
you see the bruise, un moretón.
Un moretón,
when
tú
you
lo
see
ves,
the bruise,
tú lo ves.
You can see the bruising.
Y lo puedes ver por fuera.
But there's no blood coming out from the outside.
Pero no hay sangre que sale.
Because a bruise,
porque el moretón,
is the exposure of blood vessels not on the outside but on the inside.
Es algo que se rompió por dentro.
So in other words,
so en otra palabra,
Jesus bled externally,
Jesús sangró por fuera,
for your transgressions,
por tus transgresiones,
but he was bruised internally,
pero él fue molido internamente,
for the stuff people will never know about,
por las cosas que la gente nunca sabrá,
for the dark stuff people will never hear about. How many of you are thankful,
¿cuántos de ustedes están agradecidos,
that Jesus paid the price for both the external stuff,
por las cosas de afuera,
and the stuff people sometimes don't get to see,
y por las cosas que a veces la gente no
that
ve.
It's even in the dark moments of my life,
que aún en los momentos oscuros de mi vida,
that Jesus,
que Jesús,
was wounded for me,
fue herido por mí.
And there's something about transgressions,
y hay algo sobre las transgresiones,
and iniquities,
iniquidades,
that will destroy your peace,
que destruyen tu paz.
But Jesus,
pero Jesús,
once and for all, y'all,
por una y todas,
paid the price on the cross,
él pagó el precio en la
so
cruz,
that you and I could walk in victory,
para que tú y yo camináramos en victoria,
and have the security,
y tener la seguridad,
that he paid the price for me,
que él pagó el precio por ti.
In that moment,
en ese momento,
that Jesus was on the cross,
cuando Jesús estaba en la cruz,
he dies,
él muere,
he gets put in a tomb,
y lo ponen en la tumba.
But here I came for somebody tonight,
pero yo vine aquí por alguien,
that just because it's dark,
que no solamente porque está oscuro,
it doesn't mean it's over,
no significa que se acabó.
Somebody needs to grab that in their spirit.
Alguien tiene que agarrar eso en
that
el
just
espíritu.
Because it's dark,
no solamente porque está oscuro,
it doesn't mean it's over.
No significa que se ha acabado.
It's not over.
No se ha acabado.
It's just that God,
es que Dios,
has created treasures in darkness,
ha creado tesoros en lo escondido.
And in order for God to birth the new thing he's going to do in you,
y para que Dios saque lo nuevo que él va a hacer en ti,
in order for God to birth the treasures in darkness,
para que él saque los tesoros escondidos,
sometimes he has to take the light away,
a veces él tiene que sacar la luz,
in order to incubate you,
para incubarte,
and bring out what's always been inside of
you. Y sacar lo que siempre ha estado dentro de ti.
I pray that tonight,
yo oro que en esta noche,
you begin to understand,
tú empieces a entender,
that even in every dark moment of your life,
que aún en cada momento oscuro en tu vida,
God is bringing something out of you that you've never even seen before.
Dios está sacando algo de ti ni que tú has visto.
When God needed something from Adam,
cuando Dios necesitó algo de Adán,
he put Adam to sleep.
Él lo puso a dormir.
He said, Adam, shut your eyes.
Y le dijo a Adán, cierra los ojos.
Go to sleep.
Vete a dormir.
And it was in the dark moment where he brings out a woman.
Y fue en ese momento oscuro donde él saca
and he
la
brings
mujer,
out the wife.
Y saca su esposa.
And when Adam wakes up,
y cuando Adán se levanta,
he says, whoa, man.
Y dice, wow.
And God says, woman, that's her
y
name.
Dios
it's
dice,
woman.
Whoa, whoa. All right. Mujer,
we'll
mujer.
Take it.
Es mujer.
We'll take it. It's in the moment of dark spaces,
es en el momento de la oscuridad,
where God brings things out of you,
donde Dios saca eso de ti.
And there's a man by the name of Paul.
Y hay un hombre por el nombre de Pablo.
And in Acts chapter 9,
y en Hechos 9,
I don't know if you can get it for me, Isaiah.
No sé si lo
I gotta put it on the screens just so that we can see it.
Me gustaría que
Acts
lo
chapter 9 and verse 1,
Hechos 9:1.
The Bible says that Saul,
la palabra dice que Saulo,
was making threats against the people of God.
Decía que él echaba amenazas y muerte contra los discípulos del Señor.
And he was shouting murder against the people of God.
Y él enviaba muerte contra los discípulos del
he
Señor.
He was coming after the disciples.
Él venía en contra de los discípulos.
Saul,
Saulo,
in his day,
en su tiempo,
was a very wise, intelligent man.
Era muy inteligente y sabio.
He knew what he was doing.
Él sabía lo que él estaba haciendo.
And he knew exactly,
y él sabía exactamente,
what his assignment was.
Lo que su asignación
and it was
era.
Coming to persecute the church of Jesus Christ.
Y era de venir a perseguir la iglesia de Cristo.
His assignment on the earth,
su asignación en la tierra,
was to kill the Christians.
Era para matar a los cristianos.
If you said you were a disciple,
si tú decías que eras
if you
discípulo,
said you were a believer,
que tú eras un creyente,
he was coming after you.
Él venía en contra de ti.
The Bible says that Saul,
y la Biblia dice que Saulo,
was still breathing threats,
respirando aún amenazas,
and murder,
y muerte,
against the disciples.
Contra los discípulos.
This is what's crazy.
Y es lo que es loco.
Is that some of us,
que algunos de nosotros,
are only living under a threat.
Solamente estamos viviendo bajo una amenaza.
Some of us,
algunos de nosotros,
get stuck in our mind.
Nos detenemos y nos paramos en nuestra mente.
Because in dark moments,
porque en los momentos oscuros,
oh, I feel the Holy Ghost. In dark moments,
en los momentos oscuros,
you have a decision to hear what voice you're going to listen to.
Toma la decisión a qué voces vas a escuchar.
Either you listen to the voice of God,
o vas a escuchar la voz de Dios,
or you live under the threat of the enemy's voice.
O vas a vivir bajo la amenaza
and
del
the Bible
enemigo.
Says in verse number 2,
y la Biblia dice en el versículo 2,
that while Paul,
mientras que Pablo,
it says that he went into the high priest and he asked for letters from the synagogues of Damascus.
Y le pidió cartas para las sinagogas de Damasco.
So he found
se encontró
any belonging to the way, both men and women, that he might bring them bound to Jerusalem.
A fin de que si hallase algunos hombres o mujeres de este camino,
let's
los trajese presto a Jerusalén. Vamos al 3.
And the Bible says, all right, y'all don't get it on the screen. Okay. As he journeyed and he came near Damascus, suddenly a light shone around him from heaven.
Dice, mas yendo por el camino, aconteció que al llegar cerca de Damasco, repentinamente le rodeó un resplandor de luz del cielo.
It flashed around him.
Le resplandeció.
In verse number 4,
y el versículo 4,
it says that after that light shone,
dice que después del resplandor,
Saul fell to the ground,
dice que Saulo cayó a la tierra,
and he heard a voice saying,
y oyó una voz que le decía,
Saul, Saul,
Saulo, Saulo,
why are you persecuting
¿por qué me persigues?
Now I want to make a stop right here,
y quiero parar aquí,
and I just want to tell somebody,
y le quiero decir a alguien,
how many of you are thankful,
¿cuántos de ustedes están agradecidos
for the things,
por las cosas,
that God stopped?
Que Dios paró.
How many of you are thankful for the things that should have come against you, but God stopped it? Someone shout with me, God stopped it. Someone shout with all lungs, air in those lungs, say, God stopped it. Because if you would have known what should have came against you, Saul was coming as a threat against the church, but God stopped it. Someone say, God stopped it. Turn to your neighbor, tell him God stopped it.
Dile a tu vecino, Dios lo paró.
God stopped it for your good.
Dios lo paró por tu bien.
He stopped the accident.
Él paró
he stopped
el accidente.
He stopped the overdose.
Él paró en la sobredosis.
He stopped the death.
Él paró la muerte.
Someone say he stopped it.
Alguien diga lo paró.
He stopped the cancer.
Él paró el cáncer.
He stopped the tumor.
Él paró el tumor.
He stopped the affliction.
Él paró tu aflicción.
He stopped the divorce.
Él paró el divorcio.
He stopped it.
Él lo paró.
He stopped the denial. He stopped when you should have gone through it.
Él paró cuando tú tenías que haber cruzado.
The things that were coming against you.
Y hay cosas que vienen en contra de ti.
There's moments where God stops it.
Pero hay momentos que Dios los para.
And although Saul was coming against the church,
y Saulo venía en contra de la iglesia,
Jesus comes to encounter him.
Pero Jesús viene y lo encuentra.
And the Bible says that it was a great light.
Y la Biblia dice que era un resplandor.
It's like, how is it a great light when it's already light outside?
¿Cómo es un resplandor si había luz afuera?
Because it was brighter than light.
Porque era más brillante que la luz.
It was brighter than any light Saul had ever seen.
Era algo tan resplandeciente que Saulo nunca había visto.
And Jesus says, why are you coming to persecute me?
Y Jesús le dice, ¿por qué me persigues?
You never read Saul.
Nunca lees que Saulo
coming against Jesus.
Viene en contra de Jesús.
You read Saul.
Tú lees que Saulo
coming against the people that followed Jesus.
Viene en contra de la gente que seguían a Jesús.
And because they followed Jesus.
Y porque seguían a Jesús.
He was coming against them.
Él iba en contra de él.
But Jesus says,
pero Jesús dice,
why are you coming against me?
¿Por qué vienes en contra de mí?
He says, I'm not coming against you.
¿Quién eres?
I'm coming against the people that follow you.
Le dijo, yo vengo a perseguir la gente
now,
que te sigue.
Now how many of you are thankful?
Ahora, ¿cuántos de ustedes están agradecidos? Otra pausa.
That God protects you.
Dios te protege.
That God comes to your defense.
Que Dios viene a tu defensa.
That because you say you represent God,
que porque tú representas a Dios,
his angels come for
sus ángeles vienen
you. His protection
por ti.
Is for
su protección
you.
Viene
everything
por ti.
That you need is for you.
Todo lo que tú necesitas viene por
and the Bible
ti.
Says, I'm going to finish with this.
Y la Biblia dice, voy a terminar con esto.
Continues to say in verse 5.
En el versículo dice,
that after Paul,
después de que Pablo,
put the whole chapter 9 on there, man.
Póngame ahí el capítulo 9.
The Bible says, who are you, Lord? And he said,
dice, que le pregunta, ¿quién eres, Señor?
I am Jesus whom you are persecuting.
Y él le dice, yo soy Jesús a quien tú persigues.
And verse number 6.
Y el versículo 6.
It continues to say,
continúa diciendo,
that so he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what do you want me to do?
Él temblando y temeroso dijo, Señor, ¿qué quieres que yo haga?
He said, arise
y el Señor
and
le
go
dijo,
into the city, and you will be told what you must do.
Levántate y entra en la ciudad y se te dirá lo que debes hacer.
But the Bible says, let's jump down to verse 9.
Y vamos a ir al versículo 9.
And when Paul goes,
y cuando Pablo va,
he was 3 days
estuvo ahí 3 días
without sight,
sin ver,
and neither ate or drank.
Y no comió ni bebió.
The ministry of Paul,
el ministerio de Pablo,
who wrote the most of the New Testament,
él escribió la mayoría del Nuevo Testamento.
He's the one that gives a structure to the church.
Él es el que da la estructura a la iglesia.
He's the one with the message.
Él es el que tiene el mensaje
for the body of Christ.
Para el cuerpo de Cristo.
And yet he was the same man,
pero este era el mismo hombre,
that was killing the church.
Que él estaba matando a la iglesia.
And now he's the leader of the church.
Ahora él es el líder de la iglesia.
Aren't you glad that God could choose someone like Paul?
¿No estás tan agradecido que Dios escogió a alguien como Pablo?
And wasn't looking for perfection.
Y él no estaba buscando perfección.
Then in the middle of your imperfections,
porque en medio de tu imperfección,
God still chooses you.
Dios todavía te escoge.
The Bible says,
y la Biblia dice,
that Saul,
que Saulo,
goes into a dark space.
Él fue a un lugar oscuro,
where he can no longer see.
Y él ya no podía ver.
But it was in his blindness.
Pero fue en su ceguera.
Not in his eyesight,
no en sus ojos,
but in his insight.
Pero en lo que él vio por dentro.
It wasn't the eyesight,
no fue lo que él estaba viendo.
It was the insight.
Era lo que él iba a ver.
Some of us,
algunos de nosotros,
are too busy looking with our eyes.
Estamos tan preocupados de ver con nuestros ojos.
When you're supposed to be looking with your insight.
Cuando tienes que ver con lo de adentro.
And it is this same Paul.
Y es este mismo Pablo.
That writes to the church of Ephesus in the book of Ephesians.
Que le escribe a la iglesia de Éfesos en Efesios.
May the eyes of your understanding.
Dice que los ojos de tu entendimiento.
Be opened.
Sean abiertos.
May the eyes.
Que los ojos.
Of your understanding.
De tu entendimiento.
Be enlightened.
Sean
Iluminados. In other words,
en otras palabras,
I went through a dark space,
yo pasé por una temporada de oscuridad,
to be developed,
para ser desarrollado.
And it was after 3 days,
y fue después de 3 días,
that God changes the nature of a man,
que Dios cambia la naturaleza de un hombre,
and he transforms the nature of a murderer,
y él transforma la naturaleza de
alguien
que mata,
literally the nature of a terrorist,
no la naturaleza de un terrorista,
to become an apostle of Jesus Christ,
pero para ser un apóstol de Cristo Jesús.
But it happened in a dark space.
En ese tiempo de oscuridad.
And I came to challenge each and every one of
you
in
this church.
You must learn to grow in the dark.
Que tienes que aprender a crecer en la oscuridad.
And some of y'all have to learn.
Y algunos de ustedes tienen que aprender.
That you are not being buried in the ground.
Que no estás siendo enterrado en la tierra.
You're being planted in the ground.
Estás siendo plantado en la tierra.
And things that are planted.
Y cosas que son plantadas.
Learn to grow.
Aprenden a crecer.
It doesn't matter,
y no importa,
the rejection,
el rechazo.
It doesn't matter,
no importa,
the denial,
que te rechacen.
Just because it caught you off guard,
no solamente porque te sorprendió,
it does not mean,
no significa,
that it caught God off guard,
que sorprendió a Dios.
Someone here is being developed in the dark.
Alguien aquí está siendo desarrollado en la oscuridad.
And from this moment forward,
y de este momento en adelante,
you're going to see,
tú mirarás,
how the life of Jesus Christ,
como la vida de Cristo Jesús,
after his resurrection,
después de su resurrección,
the Bible says,
la Biblia dice,
that Jesus walked the earth for 40 days,
que Jesús caminó la tierra por 40
he
días,
walked the earth for 40 days,
él caminó la tierra por 40
and he
días,
preached the message of the gospel of the kingdom of God,
y él predicó sobre el reino de Dios,
and 40 days Jesus walked the earth,
y 40 días Jesús caminó la tierra.
And he ascended to the Father.
Y él ascendió al Padre.
And he said, it's necessary for me to go.
Y él dijo, es necesario que yo me vaya.
10 days after Jesus ascended.
10 días después que él ascendió.
The Bible says.
La Biblia dice.
That suddenly.
Que de repente.
That suddenly.
De repente.
Like a mighty rushing wind.
Como un viento.
It filled what they call the upper room.
Llenó lo que le llaman el aposento alto.
There was 120 people in
eran
that room.
Eran 120 personas en ese cuarto.
And they were waiting for a promise.
Que estaban esperando una promesa.
And it was the birthing of a new church.
Y fue el nacimiento de una iglesia nueva.
10 days in darkness.
10 días en oscuridad.
10 days of silence.
10 días de silencio.
Waiting for the promise that Jesus said would come.
Esperando la promesa que Jesús había
dado. And the Bible says, and suddenly,
y la Biblia dice que de repente,
like a mighty rushing wind,
que un viento,
it filled the house,
llenó la casa,
and the Holy Spirit ascended,
y el Espíritu Santo descendió,
like tongues of fire that just filled the house,
como lenguas de fuego que llenó la casa.
Let me tell you something, church.
Y déjame te digo algo, iglesia.
We are in the season from Passover to Pentecost.
Estamos en el tiempo de la Pascua al Pentecostés.
We call that day the day of Pentecost.
Ese día le llamamos el día de Pentecostés.
Pentecost comes from the word 50.
Significa esa palabra 50.
Pentecost means
50.
Because 50 days later,
porque 50 días después,
after Jesus' resurrection,
después de que Jesús resucitó,
the Holy Spirit came.
El Espíritu Santo vino.
And he outpoured.
Y él sobrellevó.
And I want to believe,
y quiero creer,
that we as a church,
que nosotros como iglesia,
not just Revive Church,
no como iglesia Revive,
but the body of Christ,
pero el cuerpo de Cristo,
are in the greatest season of an outpour in our lives tonight.
Estamos en una temporada donde Dios va a derramar.
And I want to tell you,
y te quiero decir,
just because it stuck for you,
que a lo mejor solamente porque paró para
just
ti,
because it paused for you,
porque pausó para ti,
it does not mean God is not moving.
No significa que Dios no se
está moviendo. How many of you are thankful that God is still moving in our behalf? God is still moving in my dark moment.
Dios está moviendo en
and
mi
God
momento
is still moving on behalf of my family.
Dios está moviendo por
and God
mi
is still
familia.
Moving on behalf of my children.
Dios está moviendo por
and God
mis
is still
hijos.
Moving on behalf of my
Dios
marriage.
Está moviendo por
and
mi
God
matrimonio.
Is still moving on behalf of my household.
Dios está moviendo por mi
and
casa.
God is still moving on behalf of my business.
Y Dios está moviendo por mi negocio.
I wish I had about 10 crazy of
yo
you that could say, God is still moving. God is still moving. Come on, stand up to your feet and shout, God is still moving. God is still moving. And guess what? We're not moving backward. We're moving forward. Because everything that God intended for you. Everything that God intended for you. Everything that God intended for you. Is for you to advance. Someone say, I'm going forward in this season of my life. I'm moving forward in this season of my life. I'm going to advance in this season of my life. Nothing will stop you. Nothing will hinder you. You're being developed in the dark. Come on, lift up your hands. Lift up your hands over your
hands.
Father, we pray tonight for every person that has felt like things have been stuck and stagnant.
Que se han estado parados.
Like things that have been put on pause.
O cosas que han sido puestas en pausa.
But tonight,
pero en esta noche,
you are moving on their behalf.
Tú te estás moviendo por ellos.
You are moving in their favor.
Tú te estás moviendo por su fe.
You are bringing increase.
Tú te estás trayendo
you're bringing
incremento.
Expansion.
Estás trayendo expansión.
You're bringing more.
Estás trayendo más.
And I prophesy that this is a season of more.
Y yo profetizo que esta es una temporada de
this
más.
This is a season of more.
Esa es una temporada de más.
As the Lord increases your capacity.
Y así como el Señor va a incrementar
this
tu
is
capacidad.
A season of more.
Esa es una temporada de más.
Father, we pray, Lord,
Padre,
for
oramos
a push of more.
Que tú vas a traer más.
More, God.
Más, Dios.
More.
Más.
Thank you, Father. Hold on,
gracias, Padre.
There's several people in this room.
Hay varias personas en este cuarto.
That are in a space right now.
Que están en un espacio.
That you have been misunderstood.
Que no ha sido entendido.
You've been asking God to give you clarity.
Le has estado pidiendo a Dios que te dé claridad.
You've been asking God to give you a specific word.
Que te dé una palabra específica.
And you've had questions in your mind of why things are going the way they're going.
Y le has preguntado a Dios por qué está pasando como está
but
pasando.
But tonight,
pero en esta noche,
we want to give you an increase of faith.
Te queremos dar un incremento de
to
fe
push through it,
para pasar sobre
to push
ello,
through it,
para empujar
because
sobre
this is
ello,
not the final destination.
Porque este no es su destino final.
I came to tell someone you are not in the final destination.
Yo vine a decirle a alguien, no estás en tu destino
all you
final.
Need is an injection of faith
lo
to
que
advance.
Necesitas es una inyección de fe para
and God
avanzar.
Wants to inject some of you with faith tonight.
Y Dios quiere inyectar algunos con fe en esta
and I
noche.
Believe that if you're here in the room
y yo creo que si estás aquí en esta
and you
noche,
might say, Pastor,
y tú dices, Pastor,
I need an increase of faith.
Yo necesito un incremento de fe.
I need that increase of faith to advance.
Yo necesito un incremento de fe para avanzar.
You have felt the delay,
tú has sentido cómo has
but
parado.
You have not been denied.
Pero no ha sido rechazado.
And the Lord today
y el Señor hoy
is going to give you a supernatural impartation.
Te va a dar una impartición sobrenatural.
Because your next 50 days
porque tus próximos 50 días
are about to increase
van
and about to go up and about to elevate
arriba,
and about to go
elevar,
higher and about to
arriba,
see the supernatural.
Vas a ver lo
Father, do it now, do it now.
Padre, hazlo ahora,
if that's
hazlo
you,
ahora.
I want you to run up to this
si
altar.
Tú,
come on.
Que
if that's you
altar.
And you need an injection
si
of faith,
tú,
come on.
Ven al altar.
Come on, come on, come on, John, Anna, come on, Kyle, everyone, let's begin to minister, come on. If you need that increase of faith in your life right now, and if that's you tonight, come on, let's begin to push, push.
Vamos, vamos.
Come on, Roger, help me.
Father, let there be an increase of faith. Let there be an increase of faith over your people, over your son and your daughter. Father, let there be an increase. Let there be a stretching. Let there be a fresh impartation.
Una impartición fresca.
Come on, impartation, impartation. Jennifer.
Una impartición fresca.
Come on, push it, push it, push it.
Vamos, vamos.
on, church. Just lift up your hands here where you are. Let's just begin to worship. Father, we thank you, Lord. I hear the Lord say, though sorrow may endure through the night, joy comes in the morning. I don't know who needs this, but the Lord says there's an impartation of joy coming over your life. As I was praying for a young lady right now, the Spirit of God reminded me, I'm about to bring a mantle of joy over this house, that every dark moment and every dark space of your life will not be finalized, and you will not live under the threat of the pain and the trauma, but you will learn to grab a hold of the hand of God, and you will learn to live in the presence of God, because in His presence, there is fullness of joy. Somebody shout fullness of joy. Come on, shout it like you mean it. Say fullness of joy. Now lift up your hands. Father, I pray, Lord, tonight that as the Spirit of God begins to move. There it is. Stay right there, guys. Just stay right there. Yeah. As the Spirit of God begins to move, we're going to create a sound of joy. A sound of joy. Somebody tonight is going to break free from the depression, break free from the anxiety, break free from the embarrassment, break free from the thought of feeling overlooked and denied. The Lord says, I'm about to restore the joy of your youth. I'm about to restore the joy back to you, that whatever the enemy tried to steal, to kill, to destroy, the Lord says, I'm restoring the joy back to you. Somebody just grab a hold of that. Somebody just grab a hold of that joy. When I count to three, I want us to release that sound of joy. The joy in the river of the Lord, the joy in His presence, the joy that only comes from Him. Father, tonight, let there be a release of healing through the Spirit of joy. Let there be healing through the Spirit of joy. Let there be miracles through the Spirit of joy, God. Tonight, you will laugh again. You will rejoice again. The enemy will not win over you again. So God, release him. One, two, three, four. Hey. Come on, release. Do something you've never done. Come on, jump, dance. Jump in the river of the joy of the Lord.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
So open up the window, let the light in. Open up the window. Let the light in, open up the window. Let the light in, let the light in. Let the light in, open up the window. And let the joy in, open up the window. Let the joy in, open up the window. And let the joy in, let the joy in.
Can you shout that? Come on.
Open up the window. Let the joy in, open up the window. Let the joy in, open up the window. Let the joy in.
Come on, just throw up your hands, hey, come on, hey. Father, we thank you that the Spirit of joy is in this house. We thank you, God, that every dark place and every dark space will not be the final destination. Padre, te agradecemos, Señor, que todo momento de oscuridad, Padre, no termina en la oscuridad, sino que hoy, Padre, tú desatas un manto de gozo, el gozo de su presencia, el gozo de poder estar juntamente contigo, Señor, que en tu presencia, ahí hay plenitud de gozo. Padre, desatamos un manto de gozo sobre esta casa. We release it, God, over this place. So, joy, the joy of the Lord is our strength. Come on,
the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Come on, sing it.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Come on, prophesy, Michaela, come on.
The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Can somebody just jump?
The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Come on.
The joy of the Lord is
catch it, mama,
strength.
Catch it right there.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy
on,
of the
catch attention. Man, I need about 20 crazy, somebody to catch up with this lady right here. Come on. There it is, mama. Come on. Yeah. Come on, where are my young ladies at? Come on. I need some younger ladies up in here. Come on. There's a generational joy that the Lord is restoring tonight. Come on, ladies. Come on. I need about 20 crazy ladies just to kind of dance to the Lord. There it is. Come on, baby. Yeah. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Come on. Prophesy it one more time, Michaela. Come on, prophesy it one more time. Come on.
Oh, the joy, the joy. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy, the joy. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Everyone shout, oh,
the
joy.
The joy, the joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy, the joy. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Come on, jump, 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 jump.
The joy, the joy. The joy. The joy of the Lord is my strength. 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 The joy of the Lord is my strength.
The joy of the Lord is my strength.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Hey. Hey, hey, hey. Turn to your neighbor and just tell him, ha, ha, ha. Turn to someone and just, ha, ha, ha. The devil lost with you. The devil lost with you. The devil lost with you. You should have never came against me. You should have never come against my family. You should have never come against my bloodline. You lost with me, and now the joy of the Lord is my strength.
I lost another one. I am free. I am free. I am free. I lost another one. I am free. I am free. Oh, we are free. I lost another one. I am free. Come on. I am free. I am free.
Stay right there, Ray. Stay. All right. Let's do something right now. You're going to give your tithe and your offering. All right. So prepare that now. We're going to finish with this thing. But I'm going to change it up just a little bit. All right. So help me right here. ¿Tú te recuerdas cuando pienso lo mucho? All right. Because there comes a point in our life. All right. We're going to go a little bit old school real quick. Because when I think of the good thing that the Lord has done in my life. All right. When I think of his goodness, and when I think that all that God has done, sometimes it makes me want to jump, dance, and shout, and praise. In Spanish, we used to say, cuando pienso en lo mucho, que él hizo por mí, cuando pienso en el día, que resucitó. Quiero danzar, 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 danzar. All right. But because I don't have the voice for it, I'm going to let our singer sing it. All right. But as we give our tithe and our offering tonight, let's finish off tonight with joy and gladness in our hearts. And when you think of God's goodness, when you think of how much he's done in our lives, how much he's healed you, transformed you, delivered you, and stopped whatever was trying to come against you, tonight is a night of joy. Can you just kind of slowly sing it out?
Yeah.
So when I think about Jesus and what he's done for me, when I think about Jesus and how he set me free, I gotta dance, 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 all night.
Y'all get it? All right. We're going to sing it one more time lightly. Right? One more time. All right. Come on. Y'all got to get excited, church. Come on. One more time, Michaela.
When I think about Jesus and what he's done for me, he set me free. I gotta dance, 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 dance all night. Oh, when I think about Jesus and all that he has done for me, and when I think about Jesus and how he set me free, Jesus and what he's done for me, when I think about Jesus and how he set me free, I got all night. Come on, say, when I think about Jesus and what he's done for me, oh, when I think about Jesus and how he set me free, I got to jump, 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 jump. Any dancers in the building? Any praisers in the building?